nestled within the leafy suburb of Mossley Hill in Liverpool, L'Olivetto is an independent, family-run restaurant supported by a dedicated kitchen team. Staff at front of house always on hand with recommendations from their tasty menu to their choosing a wine to complement your dish. Call us on 0151 724 5169. That's 0151 724 5169.
To me, Irish people are the funniest in the world. They just are.
Oh, this looks amazing.
I just love any food that comes with its own home.
Everyone's a comedian.
Any nuts?
Some greens.
What do you think I am? A juggler?
Stunning.
Inspirational.
Would you look at the brushstrokes on it?
I think the reason I see comedy in everything is because I was surrounded by it growing up.
That's good.
You wouldn't know we're 105.
You're 105. Between us.
Do you know what? There's only one word for that. Absolutely cracker.
Hi, how are you?
In Ireland, one of the greatest compliments you can give someone is to describe them as a character.
If you find any pearls, give them to me, okay?
Come on, Sloco! Come on, I'm coming! You couldn't run the length of yourself!
Because as every writer knows, it's the characters you remember long after you've forgotten the story.
Fill your heart with Ireland. Discover more at ireland.com.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
The Warrington Irish Club. Friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports are shown on big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and crown green bowling teams along with arts and craft. Pop in for a friendly welcome and book your event at the Warrington Irish Club.
Nestled within the leafy suburb of Mossley Hill in Liverpool, L'Olivetto is an independent, family-run restaurant supported by a dedicated kitchen team. Staff at front of house always on hand with recommendations from their tasty menu to their choosing a wine to complement your dish. Call us on 0151 724 5169. That's 0151 724 5169.
Hello and welcome to the show. Now, have we got a special treat lined up for you tonight? The Liverpool Irish Centre was the venue for a great night's Irish music, song and dance, celebrating the Bolger Cunningham School of Irish Dancing and the Sliabh gCua Dance Club from Waterford. Sliabh gCua first performed at the Liverpool Irish Centre back in the 1970s, and since then, thanks to Monty Houlihan and the late Tommy Walsh, friendships have continued down the years, with visits to Waterford and Liverpool each year, celebrating 50 years of this great friendship. Kathleen, what a wonderful night here at the Liverpool Irish Centre. My goodness, you put on some show.
It's been brilliant. I thought it would be busy, but I never dreamed that the amount of people that would be in here tonight. It's absolutely brilliant. Fantastic.
Now, of course, this dance troupe that you've got over from Dungarvan in County Waterford has been coming back and forth across the Irish Sea for a long time. Of course, it was first started by your late dad, Tommy Wall.
It was. So when Tommy, my dad, was the manager of the Irish Centre in Liverpool at the time, there was a man that worked for him called Martin Foley, who was originally from Dungarvan. And he told my dad about his nieces and nephews, potentially, who were part of the Sliabh Set Dancing Club back home in Waterford, who had won the All-Ireland that year. And at the time, the Irish Centre in Liverpool was known for its Sunday afternoon concerts, people like Big Tom and Sean O'Shea and so on. And he said, would they come over and dance at one of the concerts? And he said they would. So they came over. Monty Hallahan, who was the teacher and the person in charge at the time, brought the group over. And that was the start of a wonderful friendship between my dad and Monty Hallahan. And they came over a couple of occasions to do these Sunday afternoon concerts. And then we were asked to go back, and then the rest is history. Before COVID, they came over to us, and in the intervening years, we would go over to them a weekend at a time. We would look after them when they came here. They would look after us when we went there, and we would have a couple of nights just full of music, song and dance like we've got tonight.
And I took on the task of bringing a group of 49 people from Dungarvan over to Liverpool. So I started dancing when I was 4 years old with Monty Hallahan, and I think ever since then, if anyone asked me what I wanted to be when I was older, I always said an Irish dancing teacher to be exactly like Monty.
Meadhbh, tell me, how did you first get involved with the Sliabh Rua Dance Club?
So I started dancing for Monty when I was four, and I think I just fell in love with everything. I fell in love with the dancing and with Monty. So I stayed dancing with him up until COVID, and then unfortunately he decided to retire. So I asked him when I was ready if I had his permission to try and keep the club going. So that's how we're here today.
Monty Hallahan, his name is renowned in traditional Irish music.
Yeah, he's been involved in dancing his whole life. Like, I took over in the 50th year of the Set Club, and they have so many All-Ireland medals. It's a big name to live up to, but we're trying our best anyway.
I think for me and for Monty, the final part of the puzzle to get it back to as close as it was before the pandemic was to get the exchange back up and running. So when we contacted Kathleen, she was so positive about everything, and here we are. So
your dad, hopefully looking down on us tonight, will be so delighted and so pleased that you've continued on this tradition.
Yeah. Well, you know, he always said that the young people have to carry it on. That first time after he passed away, it was difficult to go back to Dungarvan, but we had to do it. And it was important to carry on. Monty was instrumental in helping me and sorting me to help arrange all of the everything that went with it. And now Monty is retired and Maeve Houlihan has stepped up, and Maeve is doing a fantastic job, so I'm in the position to kind of help her along and sort of point her in the right direction with organising the weekends, and I think she's done a fantastic job.
Thank you.
Bolger was the original teacher here in Liverpool. She taught here from the 1960s. I was one of her pupils. And then in 2002, I did my teacher's exam and took over from her. But I wasn't gonna drop her name from the title of the school because she was so important in this neck of the woods. So that became the Bolger Cunningham School of Irish Dancing. However, it's by no means just me. I have Gráinne Dodson, Nuala Doyle, and all of the senior dancers there that help teach with me as well. We meet here in the Irish Centre. We're here twice a week. We're not really a competitive school. We don't go to creches, but we do. We are involved in everything that the Irish Centre does. So any kind of occasion that they require dancers, we're down here. Any kind of family day or function that's here, and out and about in the wider city region, we take dancers out to do displays anywhere and everywhere. A couple of times a year, we have a Sunday afternoon social, usually. And we have it, we usually have one at this time of year. And because the Dungarvan gang were coming over, we decided that we would combine it with our usual Sunday afternoon thing. So everybody in the class would get up, from the ones that have only been here for a week or two that can only just point the toe, to the more senior dancers who would be, you know, helping to teach and organise. So every one of them was up tonight with all of their family members, and who have all heard stories of the Sliabh Set Club and the set dancing and the music and everything. So they've all come along tonight, and it's just been a wonderful atmosphere in there. It's been fantastic. So many smiles, kids smiling, going doing ceilidh dancing. Where else? There wouldn't be many places where you'd see, you know, what, 50 or 60 kids, young kids on the floor dancing the Walls of Limerick. It was fantastic.
Saw you in there making a very special presentation to Maureen Morrison.
Yeah, Maureen is wonderful. Maureen, she was a dancer for the Bolger School. Her daughter and her son danced for us. Her two brothers were dancers. Her nieces were dancers. I'm wondering who I've forgotten. But she's been instrumental in working here at the Liverpool Irish Centre for many years. Is a real stalwart of the Irish community here in Liverpool. But she is semi-retiring, and we didn't want the weekend, seeing as it was this weekend and all her family were here to see it. We didn't want the weekend to pass without marking it in some way. But the most important job she does for us is she's here on a Saturday morning when we have our dancing class, and she makes the tea and the toast and the coffee for the parents that are here, and has a chat, has a gossip, looks after everybody that comes in here on a Saturday morning. She's an amazing woman.
That's just the way I am. Oh, that's just the way I am.
Hope you're all enjoying the show so far, and well done to Michael Coyne, a wonderful musician and singer. We'll be back with you in a few minutes.
Nestled within the leafy suburb of Mossley Hill in Liverpool, L'Oliveto is an independent, family-run restaurant supported by a dedicated kitchen team. Staff at front of house always on hand with recommendations from their tasty menu to their choosing a wine to complement your dish. Call us on 0151 724 5169. That's 0151 724 5169.
To me, Irish people are the funniest in the world. They just are.
Oh, this looks amazing.
I just love any food that comes with its own home.
Everyone's a comedian.
Any nuts?
Some greens.
What do you think I am? A juggler?
It's
stunning.
Inspirational.
Would you look at the brushstrokes on that?
I think the reason I see comedy in everything is because I was surrounded by it growing up.
That's good.
You wouldn't know we're 105.
You're 105.
Between us.
Do you know what? There's only one word for that. Absolutely cracker.
Hi, how are you?
In Ireland, one of the greatest compliments you can give someone is to describe them as a character.
If you find any pearls, give them to me, okay?
Come on, Sloco! Come on, I'm coming! You couldn't run the length of yourself!
Because as every writer knows, it's the characters you remember long after you've forgotten the story.
Fill your heart with Ireland. Discover more at ireland.com.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
The Warrington Irish Club. Friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports are shown on big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and crown green bowling teams along with arts and craft. Pop in for a friendly welcome and book your event at the Warrington Irish Club.
Nestled within the leafy suburb of Mossley Hill in Liverpool, L'Oliveto is an independent, family-run restaurant supported by a dedicated kitchen team. Staff at front of house always on hand with recommendations from their tasty menu to their choosing a wine to complement your dish. Call us on 0151 724 5169. That's 0151 724 5169.
Welcome back. This week we're at the Liverpool Irish Centre to showcase the very best in Irish music, song and dance with the Bolger Cunningham School of Irish Dancing and the Sliabh gCua Dance Club from Waterford.
Done a wonderful job in bringing up 49 of your wonderful dancers and musicians.
Yeah, like I was hoping to get maybe 30. I wasn't really sure how it was going to go, but I was delighted when everyone kept saying yes that they'll come, and they were all more than excited to come. A lot of the kids, their parents have been, so the parents know exactly what it's all about. So I think that's probably why we have so many the first year back. But yeah, we're delighted to be here anyway.
Thank you. put in hours and hours of practice with all that dancing out there. They're absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, we're practicing every Friday anyway, and we're going between score and flat at the moment as well, so we're mad busy, but sure, we all enjoy doing it, and I feel like the trip over here just kind of shows what it's all about. It's about enjoying it and everything rather than the competitions and stuff.
How popular is the Irish dancing in Dungarvan and around Waterford?
Where we're from, like, tradition is very strong. So, like, some of the kids that we have here today, their granddad was over here in the Liverpool Irish Centre doing set dancing. So it's passed down between all the generations, and I feel like the families just want to keep it going. This is a small area and it's such a strong tradition. We're having a great weekend. The weather hasn't been the best, but we're used to it anyway back home.
And the crowd really appreciated the lovely music you put on as well with your band and then your dancers.
Yeah, we have some like incredible musicians. We have so many All-Ireland medals between the group that we had, so I'm very, very lucky to have the musicians that we did. So yeah, they all did me a massive favour coming over.
Dance group, the music, they're absolutely fantastic, lovely people as well.
The music from Dungarvan is second to none. The music tonight, there was only 4 or 5 of them on the stage, but it could have been many more. And in the crowd tonight, there are a lot of former dancers and family members who have all been to Dungarvan. They might have been to Dungarvan 20 years ago, but when the music starts, there's certain tunes and there's certain, obviously, sets that you see. And we all looked around and kind of nodded at each other and said, that's it, that's the memory. The memory of listening to and watching the sets in Dungarvan, it's just tremendous.
Much of my travel, many sights I have seen. Since I left my home in, and I left the trees. From London to Boston, wherever I roam, I have to return to my old China home. Farewell to the old, and those kind folks I knew. Every sad story, I'll not tell you the truth. One day I will wander back home across the fold and take the road westward to my own side of home.
I can't let the night go by without mentioning Michael Coyne.
He's amazing. He is, again, a dancer, Maureen's brother, a dancer for the Bolger School a long time ago. His daughters were dancers with us, but in his, you know, he's singing away in there now. He's just so easygoing. He will support us, whatever we do. He's travelled to Dungarvan many, many occasions, so he knows everybody over there as well. He's just fantastic. And you pick up the phone and say, Michael, Dungarvan's coming over, I'll be there, he says. Nothing's too much trouble for him. He's fantastic.
And of course, I was delighted to see his brother John out dancing. I don't see him on the dance floor very often.
No, not too often now, but he was, his little girl Darcy is a dancer. So the two of them were out dancing the walls of Limerick, so that's great.
You've got your young son working behind the shop now.
Yeah, well, that's through Maureen. So he came here last summer for some work placement, and he was a hit with all the pensioners when he was here. The pensioners loved him. They got him out dancing and he was playing bingo and everything. And then tonight he's come along, and because the place is so busy, I think they've said to him, would you go in the kitchen? He loves it in there. He's on the till and selling the potato crisps and the nashes. No problem to him.
Kathleen, well done to you all. It's been a fantastic weekend, and tonight here, my goodness, the crowd really, really appreciated everything you done.
Yeah, fantastic. It's brilliant night. Brilliant night. We have another night tomorrow. The crowd, we're going to a restaurant in town. It'll be a smaller night. It'll be a smaller, calmer night tomorrow night. And then the gang will head off on Monday morning. They'll leave to head off to Dungarvan, and hopefully we will go to see them very soon.
Not for the parting that my sister pained, 'tis not for the grief of our mother, 'tis all for the loss of our bonny Irish lads, that my heart is breaking forever. Red is the rose that in yonder garden grows, fair is the lily of the valley, clear is the water that flows from the boy, but my love is fairer than Annie.
Wow, what a great night we had at the Liverpool Irish Centre. A big thank you to them all. They're all so multi-talented. We'll be back with some more stories from around the UK next Thursday night. Until then, thank you all for watching.